In today's video, I'm going to be comparing six of the best managed hosting providers for WordPress and help you decide which of these hosting providers you should go for when building your website. Now, just to clarify, managed hosting is quite different from shared hosting. Shared hosting usually costs just a couple of dollars a month, and you can get started absolutely with shared hosting. But if you want more reliable service, more faster performance, and you expect a lot of visitors on your website, then you should be switching to managed hosting. And this video will specifically be about managed hosting providers, not shared hosting providers. So now that you understand the difference between a managed hosting provider and a shared hosting provider, let me explain the philosophy of how we conducted this information, or how we did this survey, or how we found out which of these hosting providers is the best. Instead of relying on the information that the hosting providers give you about uptime, their speed, performance, we actually signed up for different hosting providers and ran the test ourselves. And we didn't just do one or two tests. What we did was we actually set a website with media, with content, which replicates or mimics a real website. And then we made the test. We obviously conducted the basic test of what the performance is like, what the load time is, but we also tested the same things under load, because real websites have real visitors accessing the website. So we tested this with a simulated load balancing test by sending virtual visitors to the website just to see how these hosting providers or how these websites will perform under load. And then we also did some extensive testing on geography. So we tested what the performance of these websites would be from different areas around the world. So after conducting all these tests, we took all the data, and then based on that, we'll give you comparison and live examples of which hosting provider you should go for. By the way, if you're confused with all the technical terminology I'll be using in the video, slightly a little bit, there's a link down below on the description of this video and also in the pinned comment to a hosting quiz, which we've designed specifically for beginners. So if you're wondering which hosting provider you should go for and you're not a technical wizard when it comes to creating websites, all you have to do is go and click on that button, which will take you to our website where we have hosted that quiz. There you can go and find out, and you take that quiz, and that quiz will give you the answers what you're looking for, which of the hosting providers is good for you. So the first hosting provider we'll be taking a look at is SiteGround. And SiteGround is one of the most well-recognized brand names in the hosting industry. So let's see what the performance numbers are when we looked at managed hosting from SiteGround. Here they are. As you can see on the screen, SiteGround performed extremely well in our test. The performance grade was around 95. The page size was reasonable, but that does not depend on the hosting. The page load time was 417 milliseconds, which is barely half a second. But that's just the basic testing. That means no visitors were simulated. It's just a blank slate. So obviously the performance is going to be good. But then we sent traffic to SiteGround, and let's see how SiteGround hosting performed when visitors were actually present on the website. So on the screen, you can see the graphs of how SiteGround performed under load. Just to give you clarity, the purple line that you see is the number of visitors that were simulated, the number of requests and other things you can already see on the screen. And the blue line is what you see is the response time of the server. And as you can see from the graph already, the blue line barely flinched. That means SiteGround performed almost very well under entire traffic load that we sent on the site, which means that SiteGround servers perform really well under load as well. So if you have a lot of traffic coming to your site, SiteGround servers are not going to flinch. They're going to perform extremely well under that load as well. After this test, we also conducted a geography test. And here are the numbers on the screen. You can see it right now. As you can see on the screen, SiteGround performed really, really well under all geography locations, but the response times were extremely fast in the US location. Now, one thing to note with SiteGround is that they allowed you to change your location of your server. For example, since I'm in India, if I were to build a website with SiteGround, I would choose a location like Singapore, or if a server was available in Mumbai, I would choose Mumbai, and the response time would actually dramatically drop for that particular location. So that's the overview of SiteGround's managed hosting. One other thing to note about SiteGround is that they have 24/7 technical support available, and they have friendly staff. So even if you're running into technical issues, you can always contact support and get your queries answered. With that clarified, here's a simple list of the pros and cons of SiteGround hosting. The pros is that they have awesome WordPress support, great uptime, they offer free SSL, and they have great speeds, which we already demonstrated. They also offer ultra-fast PHP and built-in performance improvements, which are available in some of the plans. They're also one of the most highest-rated hosting providers. They also offer free site migration plus 30-day money-back guarantee, and they also offer free CDNs in partnership with Cloudflare. They offer SSH plus WP CLI integration and free email accounts on all plans, including the startup plan. The only downside with SiteGround is that the advanced features like staging, JIT, ultra-fast PHP, white-label client panel, and some of the advanced features that you might need as part of your plan are reserved for the higher-tier plans. But that's just a small downside to have all the performance improvements and great support and great reputation of SiteGround. Let's go on to the next hosting provider. The next managed hosting provider we tested was WP Engine. Now, WP Engine has already a great reputation when it comes to managed hosting. And unlike other hosting providers, WP Engine is exclusively known for managed hosting. I don't think they even offer shared hosting as part of the program. So when we tested it out, we were very curious to see how they would perform with all these tests we were to perform. So let's look at the numbers. So the first test that we obviously did was just a basic test of setting our website and seeing the performance numbers without any traffic load. And you can see the numbers on the screen that WP Engine performed very well. The performance grade was 90, the page size was reasonable, but that doesn't depend on the hosting provider. The load time was pretty fast. And considering that the entire website loaded in almost half a second, the performance is already great. But how does it perform under load? That was the big question. So let's see those numbers as well. Similar to our SiteGround test, we ran another test on WP Engine and simulated sending approximately 50 concurrent users to the site just to see how the performance will play out. And you can see the overall performance was very steady throughout the server. You can see the purple line is the line that simulates how many visitors are on the site concurrently, and the blue line represents the server load time or the response time. And as you can see, almost through the entire process, the server handled all the requests pretty well. And even at the peak, the server response times was barely 125 or crossing 125 milliseconds, which is pretty amazing. So to conclude, WP Engine servers performed extremely well under load as well. Even with all the concurrent users, the servers barely flinched, and the performance was almost steady throughout the test. That means WP Engine is also a great hosting provider when it comes to managed hosting. Let's look at the geography test so that we can see what was the response times in a variety of locations throughout the world. And as you can see on the screen, server response times for WP Engine were extremely well across all geographies, especially high in the US region. Even in other regions, the response time is barely 200 milliseconds, which is amazing as well. And in conclusion, here's a short pros and cons list of WP Engine's hosting. The first advantage is that they're highly optimized for WordPress performance with fully stable managed hosting. They also offer automatic backups, WordPress pre-installed, and also premium StudioPress WordPress themes included for free. They also have a one-click staging environment, free SSL, and integrated support to add CDN service as an add-on, which makes your life easier. They also have a powerful yet easy-to-use custom hosting panel with excellent customer support team, which includes phone support and email support. The only downside of WP Engine, if I have to phrase it that way, is that they are slightly expensive than other hosting providers, but it's all worth it when you consider the great performance WP Engine provides. On to the next hosting provider. The next hosting provider we took a look at was Hostinger. Now, when it comes to Hostinger, they're primarily known for their shared hosting services, which are much more affordable than any managed hosting service. But they also offer managed hosting service, which we're curious to look at. So we conducted all the same tests with Hostinger managed hosting service as well. Let's take a look at the numbers. So the basic website test that we performed without any load performed really well. The performance grade was 91, the page size was 752, but again, that's not connected to the hosting, and the load time was 757 milliseconds, which is barely a quarter of a second. Pretty good. The next test we did is we tested the server performance under load. So we simulated around 50 concurrent visitors on the site just to see how the server would perform under load. And as you can see on the numbers on screen, the server performance remained consistent throughout. There were a few spikes in between. The response time was going up and down, but it stayed consistently under 500 milliseconds, which is excellent performance for any website. Overall, I'd say the performance of SiteGround was consistent and good under load as well. And just to clarify, the purple lines you see on the screen represents the visitors, and the blue line represents the server load time. And based on these numbers, you can see that Hostinger managed hosting performed very well under load. So if you have a growing website, a blog, or even an e-commerce store, you can use Hostinger's managed hosting services to actually host your website. Let's look at the geographical data to see what was the response time across different geographies throughout the website. As you can see on the screen, the response times were amazing throughout the board and particularly excellent in Europe and North America, which means that no matter where your visitors are coming from, Hostinger's managed services will perform excellent for all visitors from all locations. Let me just conclude by giving you a simple list of the pros and cons of Hostinger's managed hosting services. The first advantage of using Hostinger is that they have affordable pricing plans compared to other hosting providers on the list, and they also offer great performance and speed, especially considering the lower price point. They also have great customer support. They also offer security features like malware scanning and DDoS protection. The only con is that they don't have daily backups included, and some of the advanced features like a managed hosting panel or maybe some enterprise-related solution that you might need to manage your hosting is not part of the plan. Essentially, the hosting from Hostinger, especially the managed hosting from Hostinger, is aimed at small to medium businesses, not for enterprise which need a lot of control. So it's affordably priced and it offers great performance for that price. On to the next hosting provider. The next managed hosting provider we tested was Bluehost. Now, once again, Bluehost is better known for its shared hosting providers, but you might not know that Bluehost is the official recommendation by WordPress themselves when it comes to hosting providers. And Bluehost also offers managed hosting solutions, which we were curious to take a look at on how the actual websites perform on Bluehost managed hosting. So here are the numbers of all the official tests that we performed on Bluehost managed hosting. The first test was obviously just setting a website and seeing how the load times were on the website. And as you can see, the performance grade was actually very good. The page size, again, is not related, but reasonably well. The load time was barely a second, which is pretty amazing for no optimized website right out of the box. The next thing we tested was the load times under traffic. So again, we simulated the same environment, sending approximately 50 concurrent users to the website to see how the load times performed. And as you can see on the screen, the load times of the website were pretty consistent and stable. The purple line represents the number of visitors we sent to the site. And the blue lines actually tell you what the average, or I say peak load times or the current load times were. And as you can see, the average load time stayed under, I think, 300, 400 milliseconds, just spiking a couple of times over 1 second. But that's to be expected when a lot of visitors come to your site. And that is still reasonable performance for a website that is not optimized at all. So overall, the website we created on Bluehost managed hosting performed very well. And the load times were very consistent, just spiking a couple of times. But even the spikes were well under an acceptable, I'd say, load time for a traffic website. So considering that, Bluehost is also useful when you're trying to create a business website, a small website, and even for an e-commerce store. Let's look at the geographical numbers to see what was the load times across different geographies around the world. And as you can see on the screen, the server response times were pretty amazing, especially microseconds, or I say blazing fast in US regions, but still staying under 250 milliseconds throughout all geographies around the world, which is just a quarter of a second, so it's blazing fast. And here's the final pros and cons list of Bluehost, so you can decide if Bluehost is right for you. The first advantage that Bluehost offers is that they are one of the most affordable hosting providers out there, even when it comes to managed hosting. And if you use our special referral link to sign up for Bluehost, you're going to get an additional 50% discount on managed WordPress hosting, plus a free domain and free SSL. Another advantage of using Bluehost is that they are officially recommended hosting provider by WordPress themselves, so their credibility is extremely high. Another important advantage of using Bluehost is that their WordPress installation process is extremely optimized. They have built-in tools for SEO and bloggers and e-commerce sites, so you can set up your entire website throughout the setup process itself. Another important thing Bluehost offers is free migration, and they also have cPanel support. So it's a familiar environment where you can manage and set up your site. The only con or downside of using Bluehost is that some users report that their support times are slightly slower. So with this data, hopefully you'll have enough information to decide if Bluehost is the right provider for you. On to the next hosting provider. The next hosting provider we took a look at was Dreamhost. And once again, Dreamhost has a plethora of options when it comes to hosting. They offer shared hosting, VPS hosting, and they also have a WordPress managed hosting solution called DreamPress. So obviously, we took a look at all the information and ran all the tests, and here are the numbers on screen. The first test we obviously performed was just creating a website with Dreamhost and running the numbers, running the tests on what the load times were. And you can see the performance grade was exceptional. The page size, again, unrelated, but it was reasonable. The load times were slightly higher compared to other hosting providers, and the requests were, again, a fairly minimum, which is expected to be for a blank website. The next test we performed was obviously the performance under load test. So once again, we simulated around sending 50 concurrent users to the site just to see how the performance of the website will vary. And you can see the numbers on the screen. Once again, the purple line represents the number of visitors on the site. The blue line represents the server response time. In this case, apart from one big spike, the overall server response time was consistent. But you can see probably from this right-hand side column that the response times of the server is quite high. But that was our mistake. We accidentally turned off the inbuilt caching solution on Dreamhost. And then once we fixed it, we reran the test to get the actual numbers on how the website would perform. So once again, the blue line represents the server response time and the purple line represents the number of visitors on the site. And as you can see, the performance dramatically improved once the caching solution was enabled. The server response times was almost always flat, except for a couple of spikes, which is to be expected. But the overall peak traffic response was barely around 1 second, even at the peak load. So based on these numbers, you can see that DreamPress hosting performed very well under load as well. So it's suitable for all kinds of needs, and you can definitely create a website with high traffic loads on DreamPress as well. Let's look at the geographic numbers to see how the load times were throughout different geographies around the world. And as you can see on screen, the numbers are absolutely fantastic. Once again, barely close to 250 milliseconds as the peak response times and being as fast as 16 milliseconds in the US Western region. It's pretty amazing. So based on this information, here's a simple pros and cons list of DreamPress hosting. The first advantage is that they are super fast managed hosting provider service with affordable plans. The second advantage is that each plan includes custom control panels, free SSL and SSD storage, which is fast performance. DreamHost is also easy to scale, so it's suitable for budgets of different kinds. The only downside is that the staging side options are available only with the advanced plans. So if you really need a staging side, that's the only downside of using DreamHost. But you can always go to the advanced plan, pay a little more, and get all the advanced features that DreamHost offers. Let's go on to the next hosting provider. The next hosting provider we took a look at was Rocket.net. And Rocket.net is a managed hosting provider which deals exclusively with WordPress managed hosting. So our expectations were already high. But what we saw surprised us as well. Here are the numbers for a basic website test with Rocket.net. And as you can see, the performance grade is amazing. Page size is low, but that doesn't have to do anything with the hosting provider. The load times, half a second, less than half a second, pretty amazing. The number of requests is also fair. And those numbers are very, very promising. Obviously, the next test we did was a performance test where we simulated around sending 50 concurrent users to the website. And here are the numbers. Once again, the purple line represents the number of concurrent users on the site and the blue line represents the server response time. And as you can see, Rocket.net servers performed extremely well under load, barely flinching with any amount of traffic we hit. Even though the number of concurrent users on the site was consistent, the servers barely flinched and there was not even a single spike in the overall response times, which is pretty amazing. And considering that we didn't do any performance optimization on the site, the response times and the server performance is amazing. That just speaks to Rocket.net's managed hosting solution and how well optimized it is out of the box. Let's look at the geographical numbers to see what the performance is throughout different areas of the world. And as you can see the numbers on the screen, the performance numbers for Rocket.net are absolutely crushing everywhere. Barely 10 milliseconds from anywhere around the world. And that's because Rocket.net already uses a distributed network of servers to actually host your website, which is just a great performance optimization technique, which reduces the server response times and also reduces the response time throughout the world. So based on these numbers, you can understand Rocket.net servers perform extremely well under load as well. So if extremely fast performance is critical to your business, then Rocket.net is probably the better hosting choice. Let's look at the basic pros and cons list to understand if Rocket.net is the right hosting solution for you. The first advantage of Rocket.net is obviously the performance. It's absolutely crazy how well the servers are optimized, that the server response time stays consistent, and the response time throughout the geographies of the world is also pretty, pretty fast. The next advantage that they have is that they have very easy to use control panel, which even beginners can use. And of course, they have ultra secure managed hosting solutions so that your website will always, always be secure. The only downside of using Rocket.net is that they don't have much online documentation. So if you're trying to find out some solutions yourself, you might not be able to find a solution. You might have to go to a support representative, which just is an additional step to solving your problem. But apart from this, Rocket.net services and their solutions are pretty amazing as well. So now that the performance numbers of all the hosting providers has been shown to you, here's a simple table representing all the hosting providers, what pricing they offer, and a couple of additional basic features that they provide. So you can make the right call when it comes to which hosting provider is right for you. Once again, we have an amazing hosting quiz linked in the description, and also all the links to the hosting providers are also linked in the description. You can quickly click and find the best deal and the best pricing for your hosting services. So hopefully with all these tests and numbers, you should be able to decide for yourself which is the right hosting provider for you. And just to give you some context, we host a pretty big website, WBeginner, on SiteGround. So we talk the walk or we walk the talk, and we actually host or use one of these services or one of the hosting providers that we mentioned in this video as well. So make sure to make a decision and let us know in the comments which of these hosting providers you're going to pick. And by the way, WBeginner also now offers pro services. If you need help with building your website, maintaining your website, or if you have a hacked website that needs some specialized help, you can go to the link in the descriptions and go to our managed hosting services and opt for any of the services. And our expert team will help you build your website, design your website, and even recover your website if it is hacked. With this, we have come to the end of the video. If you want to continue your WordPress education, make sure to subscribe, like, share, do all that good stuff. You're watching Yuvraj from WBeginner, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.